it's Katrina. From new winged dinosaurs to finding buried treasure, here are 9 amazing discoveries. Prehistoric circle near Stonehenge. While Stonehenge is one of the most famous monuments in the world, there is a lot that we still don't know about it, and new discoveries are being made every year. As part of the ongoing Stonehenge Hidden Landscape Project, scientists recently discovered an ancient ring of deep trenches near Stonehenge and encircling the Neolithic village of Durrington Walls. This is a significant find that is helping them to better understand what life was like for the people who lived in the area 4,500 years ago. Around 2500 BC. A team of archaeologists discovered the circle of pits using remote sensing technology and ground sampling. They published their findings in the journal Internet Archaeology, theorizing that the trenches may have been used for guiding people to religious sites and/or to establish a boundary that served as a warning not to cross. University of Bradford archaeologist and lead study author Vincent Gaffney said that this makes the site the largest prehistoric site in Britain and possibly Europe. The ring is made of trenches, measuring 1.2 miles wide, with each trench or pit measuring as much as 33 feet in diameter and 15 feet deep. All of them are set at a specific distance, all paced out from a central point. While this may not seem that interesting, it is proof that people in the Neolithic era could count. Nick Snashall, the National Trust archaeologist for the Stonehenge and Avebury World Heritage Site, hailed the significant discovery as astonishing, adding that Durrington Walls is key to unlocking the story of the wider Stonehenge landscape. Durrington was for the living, and Stonehenge for the dead. This discovery is a whole new chapter to our knowledge of the ancient site, and over the past 10 years, it has slowly been revealing its secrets. These new techniques in archaeology of using magnetic remote sensing has helped to discover major things that are hard to imagine we missed before. There is much more we can see and learn about without having to dig everything up. Number 8. Bat-winged dinosaur. In May 2019, paleontologists from China announced the discovery of Ambopteryx, a dinosaur genus with leathery, bat-like wings that existed over 160 million years ago. The creature's name, Ambopteryx longibranchium, means both wings in Latin. In the words of paleontologist Jingmai O’Connor, who specializes in ancient birds, this creature probably resembled a creepy-looking dinosaur squirrel. Paleontologists were very excited, as it shows that some dinosaurs evolved very different structures to be able to fly in some form or another. It had a long wrist bone that supported leathery membranes like a bat, allowing it to glide between trees. In 2017, a farmer came across an amazing fossil and took it to the Chinese Academy of Sciences. There, they discovered that it was, in fact, not only an impressive fossil, but a fossil of a bat-winged dinosaur. It's only the second feathered dinosaur with signs of large membranes on its wings that's ever been found. Ambopteryx is classified as being part of a non-avian group of dinosaurs called Scansoriopterygidae, in case someone asks you, along with Yi Chi, the first dinosaur with bat-like wings ever discovered. Yi Chi was also discovered by a farmer in China in 2015. Scientists are still working to understand the evolution of dinosaur flight, with some experts believing that flight evolved 4 or more separate times among dinosaurs. Ambopteryx and Yi Chi are the only dinosaur fossils ever discovered that possess styliform elements, which are strange, rod-like bones that jut out at the wrist. Finding this second specimen confirms many theories about Yi Chi, most importantly that this was a real creature and that there are more like them. The Ambopteryx in the fossil had its wings folded up, so it's hard to recreate exactly what they looked like. It's most likely they would have glided around like modern-day flying squirrels and sugar gliders. You know, but scary. Number 7. An exploded star. Every atom that's found on our planet originated in a star when it ejected matter in its dying stages, but some material is much newer than others. In 2016, an amazing discovery was made in the Pacific Ocean. About 2.6 million years ago, a supernova exploded around 300 light-years away from Earth. As our solar system passed through the resultant debris, tiny particles of dust fell through the Earth's atmosphere and into the oceans. In most places, this dust has long gone, but an extensive search of the ocean floor managed to find some that remain. The search focused on finding 60 Fe, a radioactive isotope of iron that is only formed in supernova. It has a very short half-life, so in most cases, it wouldn't have survived for very long. Its exposure to water created a unique situation, though, where it formed rust and fell to to the ocean floor. Here, bacteria consumed the rust to form magnetite crystals, and the fossilized remains of the bacteria that had been found still contain these crystals. This proved that the bacteria had consumed the stardust and even proved that the supernova occurred 2.6 million years ago, and our solar system spent 800,000 years passing through its trail of debris. And now for some treasure! But first, big shout out to Dean Raynell and Brandon Williams. Thanks so much for your support! And big hello to your daughter, Brandon! If you are new here, be sure to hit that subscribe button and join us! Number 6. Fen treasure. A long hidden hoard of valuables with an estimated value of between $1 and $2 million, known as the Fen treasure, was finally discovered earlier this year. I had just put it in our video of treasures that haven't been found yet, too. An eccentric and wealthy former art dealer named Forrest Fen hid the cache of gold and jewels in the US Rocky Mountains. In 2010, he published a cryptic 24-line poem containing clues about the hoard's whereabouts, prompting treasure seekers from all around to travel in search of it. Fen's cache became controversial when people began getting hurt, and worse, amid their pursuits. At least 4 treasure seekers lost their lives, and countless others found themselves in terrifying predicaments. But apparently, the search is over! Someone has found the treasure! Fen's treasure was officially reported as found in June of this year. Fen announced the discovery in his blog, but did not disclose the lucky finder's identity per the individual's wishes for privacy. The treasure chest was found by a man I did not know and had not communicated with since 2018, Fen wrote, also pointing out that the man found the chest exactly where he had left it a decade earlier. He posted photographs of himself going through the bronze chest, which he said was darker than it was 10 years ago. Inside, there was a weathered silver bracelet, numerous gold coins, a rusty key, and gold nuggets, among other valuables. While rescue personnel are probably glad the Fen treasure was found, given the tendency for treasure hunters to put their safety at risk, fortune seekers reported feeling a lack of closure following the discovery, particularly because Fen did not report the location of the chest. In Fen's words, "The finder wants me to remain silent, and I always said the finder gets to make those 2 calls, who and where." The disappointed enthusiasts continued to speculate about where the treasure was found, with many believing that they knew the location, but that the finder beat them to it. Number 5. Champagne-scented orchid. In 2017, botanists in northern Madagascar's Mahajanga province encountered a champagne-scented orchid species with large, beautiful petals. The little-known flower is just one of many species of lovely-smelling orchids and wildflowers in general that are found throughout Madagascar, which is known for its unique plant and animal life. But early collectors did not spend much time in this particular region of the country, however, due to its relative inaccessibility, leaving the flower and several other unique orchids unnoticed by researchers until recent years, when Anton Seider from the Botanical Gardens of the University of Vienna and his wife Krista made the days-long trek to the area. The previously unreported champagne-scented species, named Cynorchis christae after co-discoverer Krista Seider, has a nearly 2-inch-wide, broad white flower, larger than the flowers of C. gigas, which until now was the most impressive species in the genus. Their discovery drew researchers from the Kew Royal Botanic Gardens, who reported that the orchids grow abundantly along roads and rock faces. Locals, who were long familiar with the flower, were apparently somewhat amused by the visitors' excitement. "It's like a group of people suddenly studying the daisies growing in your front lawn," lead study author Johan Hermans told The English Garden. Hey, even daisies are special to someone. Number 4. Mohawk dinosaur. While working in southern Argentina, paleontologists uncovered the fossilized remains of Bajadasaurus pronospinax, a giant herbivorous dinosaur species that boasted a mohawk-like arrangement of spikes along its head and body. The researchers described their findings in a 2019 scientific report published in the online journal Nature. B. pronospinax wandered South America's Patagonia region, which encompasses parts of Chile and Argentina. It lived approximately 140 million years ago during the Cretaceous period and around 75 million years before the famous Tyrannosaurus rex emerged into existence. The 2-foot-long spikes protruding from its back were likely keratin-covered bone structures, much like the horns on today's antelopes. Hailing from the sauropod family, the roughly 30-foot-long creature is part of the Dicrosauridae group of dinosaurs, who are characterized by their gigantism, but for having relatively small bodies for this condition, and by their short necks compared to most other sauropods. They also have other unique features, such as their distinctive vertebral column with paired long neural spines, said the researchers. The newly discovered species was probably non-aggressive, and most most likely used its spikes for defensive purposes against predators. This distinctive feature also probably made the dinosaur less prone to attacks to begin with, because after all, it probably seemed like a bad idea to go after something with a row of thin, sharp spears running along practically the entire length of its body. Number 3. Prehistoric mine. Underwater archaeologists working in the Mexican state of Quintana Roo recently discovered a prehistoric ochre mine in a flooded cave complex. The mine dates back somewhere between 10,000 and 12,000 years, making it the oldest mine ever discovered in the Americas, according to Mexico's National Institute of Anthropology and History. Within the 3.73-mile complex are a half-mile of ochre mine tunnels containing remains of human-set fires, mining debris, stone tools, navigational aids, and digging sites. The discovery indicates that people went into the caves in search of iron-rich red ochre, a pigment they used for decoration and rituals, which early peoples around the globe incorporated into cave paintings, rock art, burials, and other structures. The landscape in this cave is notably altered, which leads us to think that prehistoric human beings extracted tons of ochre from it, perhaps seeing the need to light bonfires to illuminate their space. Fred Davos, co-director of the Research Center for the Aquifer System of Quintana Roo, or SINDAC, said in a statement. Davos and co-director Sam Meacham first visited the site in 2017. So far, no human remains have been found in the mine, although skeletons have been found discovered in other parts of the cave complex. There is lots left to explore. Number 2. Van Gogh drawing. For over a century, an unidentified Vincent van Gogh drawing sat in a privately owned collection, more or less collecting dust as it was passed down from one generation of owners to the next. In 2017, researchers looked into the drawing's origins and discovered that Johanna van Gogh Bonger, the widow of Vincent van Gogh's brother, Theo, had consigned the artwork to Dutch art dealer J.H. Dubois in 1911. Dubois sold the drawing 6 years later in 1917, and it fell into obscurity from there. An art advisor working with the owner several years ago noticed the piece. Suspecting that it may be a Van Gogh original, they sent it to the Van Gogh Museum for further examination. A team of experts led by senior researcher Theo Meedendorp determined that the artwork's characteristics were consistent with other works by the Dutch artist. The paper is the same type, size, and has the same watermark that Van Gogh used in his early drawings in Paris, Meedendorp told Artnet News. This led us to believe that the drawing is really by Van Gogh. What's more, the analysis led researchers to reanalyze another similar suspected Van Gogh work called The Hill of Montmartre, which was written off as inauthentic in 2001. With two comparable pieces, the team reversed the museum's past decision and relabeled the drawing as a genuine Van Gogh work. As renowned as Vincent van Gogh is today for his post-impressionist skills, he was no more than an inconsequential backwater to the art world during his lifetime, throughout which he struggled with profound mental health issues that he ultimately succumbed to when he tragically ended his own life in 1890. Number 1. Blue Whale Graveyard. In 2011, along the Pan-American Highway in northern Chile's Atacama region, paleontologists began excavating a remarkable collection of what eventually amounted to over 40 ancient marine mammals. The fossilized remains were originally discovered by highway workers embedded in sandstone, roughly 2/3 of a mile from the ocean and 120 feet above sea level. Most of the 40 skeletons were baleen whales, and they were scattered across 4 distinct levels throughout the area, indicating that the animals perished in 4 separate mass stranding incidents. The majority of the creatures were found belly up, suggesting that they passed away at sea or shortly after they washed ashore, Nick Pyenson, curator of fossil marine mammals at the Smithsonian's National Museum of Natural History, told the Washington Post. Pyenson and his colleagues, who published a research paper describing their findings in the Proceedings of the Royal Society B, believe that the mass strandings were likely caused by harmful algal blooms known as red tide, which, according to Pyenson, is the only obvious possible cause for animals so high up on the food chain to perish en masse. The skeletons are somewhere between 6 and 9 million years old, experts estimate, although they believe the 4 mass strandings happened over a 10,000-year period. Some of these fascinating fossils are housed with the Marine Mammal Collection in Building 25 of the Smithsonian Institution's Paul E. Garber Storage Facility in Suitland, Maryland. Yikes! Who knows what else they have in there? Thanks for watching! Which discovery was your favorite? Let me know in the comments below, and remember to subscribe and give this video a thumbs up for more! See you next time! Bye!